So we're going to build a reaction-based game here, which is going to be based on darts. So the way it works, just to sort of show you first, is we are going to type in a couple of names here, and the game will give us a randomly generated amount of seconds, and we've got to press the enter key to throw the dart. And the closer we throw it to the amount of seconds that has been generated, the higher score we get. So I pressed enter after 1 second and I got 180, which is the most we could get. Here it's asking me to throw the dart after 4 seconds. And if I press the enter key now, it's told me I've pressed enter quite a long time after that, so I didn't get any score. So what happens is the score eventually goes down. So I'm on 200 at the moment. And it's first player to get to zero in the least amount of darts wins. So it's kind of got a reaction style element to it, in that we have to press the enter key within a certain period of time. So how are we going to build this? Well, we've got to start fairly small, and with most sort of larger programs, you've got to break it down. You've got to kind of deconstruct it a little bit. So we need to figure out the reaction part of this first. And I've just put in comments up here what I want to do. So I need the time in seconds from point one, and then I need the time in seconds to point two, which is when I press enter. And I need the difference between both of them so I can work out how long the reaction is between when the request comes up for the seconds and when I press the enter key. So we can do that by starting with importing a library called import time, and this looks after the seconds element of it. So what I'm going to do is just start off with a variable called begin, and this is going to be the time at the start of our program in seconds. So I'm then going to make a new variable called timer, and I'm just going to make this an input. And I'm just going to have something like press enter to stop the timer. Now we're going to change all this as we go through the program, but I just want to get this section of the program working. So I then need an end point. So same thing, time.time. So once the program runs, the seconds will start counting, and they'll carry on counting until I press enter for this input, by which time this line of code will run and it will count the amount of seconds at the end time. I now need to find out the difference between the two. So I'm just going to make a new variable called elapsed, and it's just going to be a simple sum here, end minus begin. And then we're just going to print it. Print the elapsed time is elapsed. Okay. So this should give us a time in seconds between the start time and then when I press enter. So let's see what happens. Okay, so the timer will have started down the bottom here, and I'm just waiting. And if I press the enter key, it gives us the amount of seconds between the start of the program and when I press the enter key. So 6.3, da 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 da. Now, the obvious problem with that is it's got loads of decimal points. So later on in our game, when we want to compare the time that we've taken to the time that the game has suggested we need to use, it's going to be difficult with all the decimals. So we just need to tidy it up a little bit. So what we're going to do is we are going to do this: elapsed equals, oops, int elapsed. And get the spelling correct. Elapsed. Okay, so what that will do, that will turn elapsed into an integer, a whole number. Okay, so it will discard any decimals. So let's have another look now at the program. So the time will have started, we can't see it, but it has, and I'm just going to leave it. I'm just going to press enter now, and that's given us 6 seconds. Okay, so we've now got a reaction timer here, which measures the time from the start of the program to when we press enter in seconds.